Hello and welcome to another video on endocrine physiology. In this video, we are going to talk about oxytocin. The first thing we are going to cover is what the hormone actually does. Oxytocin has two major effects. The first one is that it's responsible for milk ejection from the breasts. How does that happen? Well, we know that milk is stored in alveoli, in the mammary gland. And when a baby suckles, sensory receptors in the nipple get stimulated. And this stimulus is then transported to hypothalamus. And hypothalamus causes neurohypophysis to release oxytocin. Remember that oxytocin, together with antidiuretic hormone, actually gets produced in neurons in the hypothalamus, and they are stored in axons of these neurons, but these axons are located in neurohypophysis. And when the hypothalamic neurons are stimulated, hormones are released from the axons into neurohypophysis. So that's exactly what happens here. Then oxytocin is transported by blood to the breasts, and here it causes contraction of myoepithelial cells around the alveoli. And this contraction forces the milk into milk ducts and eventually into the nipple. This process is called milk ejection or milk letdown. Okay, so the second effect is that oxytocin causes uterine contractions, or more specifically, contractions of uterine smooth muscle. These contractions are believed to be at least partially responsible for causing birth of the baby. And for that reason, oxytocin is also used for inducing labor. So these were the hormone's effects. Now let's look at the way it's regulated. The major stimulus for oxytocin secretion is suckling, which we've talked about. We said that when the baby suckles, it stimulates sensory receptors in the nipple, the signal gets transmitted to hypothalamus, and hypothalamus causes neurohypophysis to secrete the hormone. However, there are also other factors that cause oxytocin secretion. The sight, sound, or smell of the baby, or even the dilation of the cervix during labor or orgasm. I think when you consider oxytocin's effect, this makes sense. Okay, so this is it for oxytocin. I hope you found this video helpful. For more videos on physiology or medicine in general, please subscribe. Thank you again, and until next time, don't forget that medicine can be easy.